So, let's continue with the hints for the preparation of the tender dossier for competitive negotiated procedure that we have prepared for you in order to help you to prepare properly your tender dossier, and also in a fast way if you want to. First of all, let me present you the structure of the tender dossier. The tender dossier is in one single annex, in this case it is the Annex 27, and it is split in six parts. There is a letter of invitation to tender, there is a supply procurement notice, instructions to tenderers, draft contract and special conditions, including annexes. So we have the draft contract, special conditions, Annex 1, Annex 2 and 3. Then we have the Annex 4, that is the budget, and the Annex 5, that are forms. And then we have further information, administrative compliance grid and evaluation grid, and then the last part, that is the tender form for a supply contract. So as usual, we have prepared these hints for the preparation of the tender dossier, and we advise you to print them and to have them next to you when you are going to prepare the tender dossier. Preparation of the tender dossier is, if you want to, possible to be split in two parts. One part that is the preparation of the technical specification, that is quite time consuming. As we said already in the previous presentation, it is demanding and it is the longest part, because you really, depending on what you want to buy, you really must be very precise. And if you want to buy a lot of different items, you need to prepare technical specification for a very large number of items, and that is very time consuming. And the rest, that is the preparation for the other items, that is very easy going. And as you will see today, I think in 1 hour, 1 hour, 15 minutes, we will be able to fill in all the forms that are necessary to prepare the tender dossier, but not the technical specification, that is another type of activity. So in our hints for the preparation of the tender dossier that I have here in front of me, you can see them in the computer. The recommendations that we have is to start the preparation for the tender dossier from the preparation of the Annex 2 entry, the technical specifications and technical offer. Of course, we prepare the technical specifications and then the tenderer will prepare the technical offer. So let's open our file. Let's see where it is. I was preparing it already, Annex 27. So in the middle of our document, we have the technical offer, technical specifications. So we start the preparation selecting a title for our project. A title that could be the title of the grant, project, and a short summarizing title describing this specific tender. For instance, promotion of development in Spaccaforno. Supply of IT equipment. Let's make the case that we are making a project, we have a grant that aims at promoting Spaccaforno under a touristic point of view, and then we have to supply, we need to buy some IT equipment that is going to be used by the tourist office to make some research on tourism development. Then we have to include the tender reference. As usual, for the tender reference, we use a number that is a mix of the call for proposal number, of the number of our contract, grant contract, plus the number, this one, of the tender that we are launching. This would be the fifth tender that we are launching. We are in an advanced phase of implementation of our project. So we copy this one. and we insert. Let's go on with the preparation of this part of the document, of the technical specification. We are in Montenegro, in our examples, Montenegro. So the equipment must be appropriate to work in Montenegro. It's important to specify the country, because there are countries that have extreme weather conditions, and therefore it is important to mention it. Then we should prepare our technical specifications. Item number, specifications required. This part here will have to be filled in by the tenderers, and this part by the evaluation committee. How we fill in the specifications? We are not doing it now. We have to insert the name of the item to be procured, for instance, car, computer, table, whatever it is, you do. And then we insert technical specifications of the item to be procured. For instance, in the case of cars, we will give some information on consumption of benzene, lower than 7 liters per 100 kilometers. But we must be very precise in this technical specification, not only one item. Otherwise, too many cars would fit in there. We have to build clear technical specification. It is not binding us to buy one car, but it is giving us the possibility to buy a number of cars that would be fitting in our organization, but without being so precise to say we want this brand or that brand. In the case of computer, you see hard disk, for instance. Always very important to see the way we write technical specification. For instance, fuel consumption lower than 7 liters per 100 kilometers. So it can be 7, it can't be 8, but it could be 6 or 5. We would be happy to have it. Hard disk at least 100 giga. It could be 110, 120, 500. For us it would be fine, but not 90. However, there are some information that are a bit more precise that you have to provide, because these are standard, existing standard, like mattress, 9 centimeters times 200 centimeters. This is a standard. You can't say at least 9 centimeters, because you could receive a mattress of 2 meters and you have a small net where to put it, and it doesn't work. Number of working wheels, it can be 2 or 4, not 5 or 6 or 7, I mean. The size of the wardrobe could be with 180 times 60, plus or minus 5%. You could have some way to write technical specifications. However, we have some examples that were published either on the website of the Union of Municipalities of Montenegro under www.uom.co.me, or under the EuropeAid website, where there are a lot of supply tenders all over the world for whatever you can imagine that were put forward. So you have plenty of places where you can look for technical specification to inspire yourself. Of course, it is not a good idea to copy this technical specification, because they were prepared thinking carefully of one project that it is not our project in this specific case. So. But in terms of the instructions, you can follow the philosophy that is there. So let's assume that we have filled in our technical specification for all this IT equipment we want to buy, computer, printers, laptops, whatever it is. Then we continue with the request of additional information. For instance, we ask the normally the supplier to provide us the description of the warranty, and in case we need maintenance, like it is the case in this case because we want to buy computers, we also ask the tenders to give us information about the authorized local service support in Montenegro, because we are in Montenegro, we said. Montenegro. in capital letter, but that is something that is not so relevant, but let's be precise in Montenegro. So once that we have prepared Annex 2 and 3, that these are together, we go back to the beginning of the document, we put ourselves here, and we look again at our hints. And our hints is recommending us, sorry, I was forgetting one detail. When you, but I was somehow speaking of it, but I want to be a bit more precise because for you it is important. When you are writing technical specifications, you are not referring to brand names. You don't say, I want a car this brand, I want a computer that brand. However, sometimes there are some specific technical specifications where the reference to a brand can be useful. You say, this brand or equivalent. This is something that's making the life of the person that is preparing the technical specification easier, because you say, I want to have this brand or equivalent. But that is making a bit harder the life of the evaluation committee, because the evaluation committee, when receive another product that is not the one of the brand, will wonder, is it equivalent or not? So if you want to be mild and kind with the member of the evaluation committee, you should avoid as much as possible the use of this or equivalent, because it will give additional work to the evaluation committee. Or the tenderer will just use the brand you are including there, and that is also not the best to be done. However, we know very well there are some products, I don't make names because I don't make any advertisement, that are almost unique. So practically, either you use that or you have not a replacement. And in IT, we have a number of them. So, but to be very cautious in the preparation for your technical specification. So let's go back to the beginning and let's look at our document. And in our document, there are some keywords to be searched and to be filled in so that we are preparing properly our technical specification. The first keyword to be used is in insert title, find. Insert title. So we have a number of insert title. The title we were already writing in the Annex 2-3. Let's go there to copy the title. And to write it down. Title of the project, so that we don't have any inconsistency in our documents. Again, contract title, insert title. The same here, the title in the administrative compliance grid. You see, there is an administrative compliance grid that is very important. We will see, you have seen when we were speaking of the evaluation, the technically and administrative compliance. A tender is compliant administratively if it is compliant with this grid that is included. So everybody is informed of what we want to. Yeah, let's insert the title. Title of the contract. Again, we insert the title. And here, title of the contract, we insert the title. So this is the first keyword to be used. You see, in one minute, we have written down most of the titles that are requested by the tender dossier. Then we go to insert number of the call for proposal. Insert the number of the some mistakes. Sometimes it happens. Insert the number. There is a ah no, it is not, in fact, it's not insert the number, it is insert number. Insert number of the call, of the call. Okay, we have here a number. This one is the number that we were using before. We have also it here, so we copy from this example in this case. And we insert the number in the where it is missing. All the time that one example has been used, we eliminate it. Insert the number. Here too, we have to insert the number. And we can eliminate the example. Again, we look for insert number of the call for proposal. We replace it. You see, it is relatively simple work to be done. The tender reference here, we insert the number. You see, you have always the example, so it is always helping you, so that you don't have doubts about. And finally here, we insert the number again. So this is for insert the number of call proposal. Then we have insert reference, that is the same, but with a different reference, with a different name, but it is the number of the call proposal. No, this is a reference to the program financing the grant project. You can see you can make mistakes. So this one is to be done later on. Insert reference, sorry, it happens. You must be careful, like I was careful. I was almost making the mistake, but I didn't the mistake. So, and as long as you don't make the mistake, there is not a problem. Europe aid. So let's copy it properly. Copy. Let's fast. So you can see, you can be relatively fast. So in the preparation of your tender dossier, of course, this one is an example, but when you do it for your real project, you must be a bit more careful than we are now. Now I want to show you how it works, the tool that is helping you to fill in with a relative speed the entire document. But more than the speed, for me, is important to avoid the inconsistencies, because the inconsistencies are the main problems that we have with tender dossier, that we write in one part one thing and another part another thing. And then the tenderers not always discover this inconsistency in the tender phase. They will discover probably in the contract phase, and then it will be, or we will discover it during the evaluation, because one tenderer is offering something, another tender is offering something else. And then all of that becomes very problematic for the robustness of the procedure. And we could be forced to cancel the contract because we are not able to decide what is the correct one. Okay, this one is the other one that we are not taking into account now. Then, after reference, insert name and address of the grant beneficiary. Insert name and address. We have not yet written the name and address of the contracting authority. Let's say that the contracting authority is the municipality of Spa Ca forno Turg Mario Mineo for spacca forno Montenegro. So this is the address of the contracting authority. We copy it so that we have it ready to be passed in all the other positions. We have to check carefully. Name address of the granted beneficiary, it fits in this case, and we passed. Name address of the granted beneficiary, it fits, and we passed. Again, here, this is the financing guarantee form. In the guarantee, we write it down, no less. Name, address of the, that is a tender guarantee, and we write it down too. So you can see, very easy. We have seen all of them. Then insert precise address. Insert precise. So where should be delivered the supply that we are going to buy? It will have to be delivered. Let's make the case that it's going to be delivered to our municipality. But it could be not to, to be delivered in this address, but in another address. To simplify our work, consider it is an example. We write the same address, but be aware that it could be another one. And insert precise. Where the tenders should be received, that is most normally to be received at the municipality, at the contracting authority. That is quite common to be that address. So we don't have any more insert precise. Another keyword is contact name. Contact name, this is the project manager, that for this project it's me, Fabio Drago. Then we look for another keyword, that is insert address. Insert address. Insert address of the contracting authority. That is the one that we have in our memory already decided, municipality of Spaccaforno. And address here, we insert the address. And like that, we have all the addresses inserted. Name and address of the contracting authority. Name and address of name address of the company, no. Name address of the supplier, not. Name address of financial institution, not. Name address of the, no. We have already filled in this information. Place and address. Place and address. In the premise of the opening session can be done in the premises of the municipality as well as in another place. For instance, in our program, the one that is under our technical assistance, normally the opening session is kept in our office and not in the office of the municipality, because it is more convenient for the evaluation committee to be in our office, and then it's also important because the technical assistant can give some advice during the evaluation process. However, most normal is that the opening session is taking place in the premises of the beneficiary. So let's write it down. Clarification meeting site visit. We don't organize for a supply of IT equipment a clarification meeting site visit. So in this case, we eliminate this option, writing down that there will not be any clarification meeting site visit to be organized. There could be, for instance, a case that we are buying pumps for a water supply system. In this case, a site visit is necessary, but in this specific case, it would be a waste of time. This is the opening session, in the timetable in the premise of, we say that we do it in the municipality. So we write down. So you can see here that with few operations we have already checked a lot of part of the tender dossier and we have inserted the correct text that is relevant. Next is to be checked is insert name of the project manager. Insert name of the project manager. That is still me, Fabio Drago. Insert the name of the project manager again, Fabio Drago. Who is receiving the offer is Fabio Drago. Or his delegated colleagues. No. Project manager, yes. Fabio Drago again. This case not, because it is in red, that is the project manager of the contractor, we will know later on when we will award the contract. So this one, it's not Fabio Drago. No, no, and no. Insert fax number. The fax number of the municipality of Spaccaforno, let's invent it. 00382202233344. Please don't call this number. Hopefully it doesn't belong to anybody. Again, the fax number 00382202233344. And the last fax number is the fax number of the contractor. We don't know it, so we will include later on when we have awarded the contract. Next one is insert email and email address of the project manager. Insert email. Email of the project manager. It is fabio.drago. At berlin.d. Fabio.drago at berlin.d. Let's and that is the email of the contractor. It is not to be inserted now. Insert locality country. Insert locality country. We say that the project is taking place in Spaccaforno, Montenegro. We copy this one. Copy. The equipment in Montenegro. Yeah, it is enough to write just Montenegro because it would be too much. Contains Spaccaforno is a small locality. Of course, if we are not in a country that is more like Montenegro, but we are, I do not know, in a large country like Serbia, and the project is in Belgrade, we would write Belgrade. The project would be in Italy. It is not the case, of course, because Italy is already a member state, so it's not under this type of project, but you wouldn't write in Italy. If you are in Rome, or you are in Palermo, or you are in another city, you would really write down the place, the close place. But in our case, Montenegro is a small country, and Spaccaforno would be a very small municipality in the country. Blah, blah, description of the arrangement and so on and so forth. Support in Montenegro. And here again we write Montenegro, Spaccaforno Montenegro, because they must be delivered not generically in Montenegro, but in Spaccaforno. That is very important. Once that we have finished this part of using these keywords, we have to start from the beginning, and we need a bit of patience, because we have to include still a number of information that are relevant. We have eliminated a lot of a considerable number of items. We have already checked them out, but we have not completed our work. So let's start from the beginning. Here there was an insert title that was missed. We will write it down now, and we will eliminate the example. The tender reference, we were writing it here. We will copy. And we will write there. To Mr., this is the person that you are sending the invitation. So you will have to insert the name. Name and address of the company. Supply of IT equipment. You can insert also the full title. It doesn't matter, it is not a real problem. There, Mr., Mrs., please insert the name of the company that you are going to deal with. Then each company, you will have to prepare this 3, 4, 5 times. Each tenderer that you are inviting must receive its own request and should not be informed about who else has been informed, who else has been invited. So that is a good measure to avoid that the companies can make some kind of agreement behind your shoulder. Let's issue the procurement notice today, that is the 27th of July, 2013. The title is already put, so we can eliminate this example. Location, Spaccaforn, procedure, competitive, negotiated. So once that we have completed the search of the keywords for replacement, we can start looking into our tender dossier from the beginning to see whether there are additional amendments to be done. So we start from the beginning again, looking for parts that must be filled in. Here we have to insert a reference to the program financing the grant project. In our case, it is the Municipal Development Grant for Small Infrastructure. We copy it and we write it, we paste it here. And once we do that, we eliminate the reference. And the same, the financing, who is financing this project? It is the European Union, the municipality, the government of Montenegro, and the municipality of Spaccaforno, in accordance with the rules of the IPA program. So we copy it and we fill it in here. Voila, this one a bit ahead, this one a bit ahead. The example we can eliminate as usual. Contracting authority we were already inserting in the beginning, municipality of Spaccaforno. Selection and award criteria, that is very important. The annual turnover of the tender for each of the last two accounting years must exceed at least a number between 3 and 10 times the offer they are going to put forward. Let's assume that it is an offer for competitive negotiated of, I don't know, 30,000 euro. So we can say that we want to have a company that is having 5 times bigger the turnover. So it would be 150,000. So we insert here the number 5. So that we are confident that it is not too small, but not even we need a very, very, very big company. So we have also to consider what the market can offer us and so on and so forth. Professional capacity of the tender based on so on and so forth. At least a certain number of people should be working for this company. We expect a company with a turnover of 150,000 euro. So we can expect that there are 3 people working, the minimum. 3 people working there in this sector of selling IT equipment. In case of equipment requiring maintenance, we said that before when we prepared the specification that we need maintenance, so we insert this sentence here. And we go on. The tenderer has completed successfully at least, let's say, we have to select a number of contracts similar to ours. I would say 2 is enough for such a contract. We must be a bit balanced in our decision. Because what we have to consider, it's true that our contract is a bit large. So we have to have somehow a system that is making the description of the companies to be consistent. The deadline for submission of the tenders, this is at least 30 days, better 37 days. Today it is the 27th of July when we are publishing the procurement notice, or better say, when we are publishing the procurement notice will be 27th of July plus 37, we go to the 4th of August, we go to around the 4th of September, let's put around the 5th. Let me check whether there are Saturdays and Sundays in this period so that we avoid them. July, August, September, after the 4th. The 4th is a Wednesday, so the 4th could be even fine. But let's be, a bit larger because there is summertime in between and we know that companies are not working so much. Let's put the 10th of September. At 10 a.m. 10/09/2013 at 10 KM. Any tenders we received after the deadline will not be considered. The opening session, we can make the same at 11 o'clock, for instance, at 11. A dot M dot on the same date, that is the 10, we said, the 10/09/2013. I always discourage people to put as deadline 12, because 12, you should put 12 p.m. if you want to make it at noon, and companies normally not always are informed that 12 p.m. is noon. And they can believe that 12 p.m. is midnight, and that would make things a bit tragic. Legal basis, normally we insert the number of the call for proposal, and if there is something else to be inserted, we would insert. In our example, we will have that the call for proposal plus the conditional grant of the government of Montenegro as a legal basis for this tender. And we are going to insert it here. Always, when we have co-financing coming from more than not only the European Union, but also from the country like the government of Montenegro in this specific case, it's important to acknowledge it in the tender. Let's continue. Now we are in the instruction to the tenderers. What do we want to do? That is a very important part. Subject of the contract, the subject of the contract is the supply. Delivery, I would say. We have to select what we are expecting them to do. Supply, delivery, unloading, installing, commissioning is not necessary, maintenance, after sale service by the contractor of the following goods. Okay, let's eliminate the commissioning. Let's leave all the rest. Eliminate also the after sales service. Let's leave just like that, the basic. Here, we should insert the items, the names of the items that we want to buy, that we were preparing in our technical specification, if we had prepared, one by one, and the quantity we want. For instance, computer type X, 10 pieces, computer type Y, 5 pieces, printer type Z, 3 pieces, and so on and so forth. So this is item, name, and quantity, item, name, quantity. The implementation period shall be a number, we have to insert how many days it's necessary to implement this contract. Let's say we are having a small contract, but nevertheless it is going to be open locally, not open locally, it is with a competitive negotiating procedure. A certain number of companies that we expect to have a certain size, because we have invited them, and well, let's put 90 days. 90 days is very common implementation period in supply contract. Shall be 90 days. No site visit because it is a banal IT supply. We can cancel the site visit. The deadline for submission of tenders, we said it was the 10th of September. The 10th of September, we said? Let me check. 10th of September, 10 a.m. 10/09/2013 at 10 a.m. And therefore, the deadline for request of any additional information would be 21 days before, that is the 20th of August, 2013, 3 o'clock in the afternoon, because we closed the office on that time. And the deadline for any additional information would be on the 30th of August, 30/08/2013, without specification. We can check whether these times are fine. Yes, they are fine. Both the 30, that is on a Friday, and the 20, that is on a Tuesday. Of course, in my case, it is just an example. If I make a mistake, it is not a problem. When you are preparing your tender dossier, be very cautious in the selection of the dates, because these are always the type of problems that are annoying the contracting authorities. Tender opening session, we said already that will be on the same date, 1 hour later, copy. Past 11. Notification of award, 10 of September, it will be end of September, beginning of October, let's write October 2013, and signature of the contract will be between end of October and November, let's write November 2013. Let's continue with our work. But you can see it is relatively simple to fill in the tender dossier. There are not too many information to be included, but still we have to go on inserting all the information that is missing. How long should be the warranty? I would say for computer it's 1 year. 1 year warranty, and in case of equipment requiring maintenance, that is our case, we have to insert the next phrase. And we do so. Pricing. Here we have to insert the quota not financed by the European Union. You know, you have your grant contract that is financed by the European Union, the eligible cost, you refer to the eligible cost, not to the accepted cost. The quota of co-financing, let's make an example, to be 25 is the local co-financing and 75 is the EU financing. So in this case, the cost of not financed would be 25%. And here the EU co-financing would be the complement to 100, meaning 75%. Here it is the country where the grant takes place, it is in Montenegro. Cost. Joint ventures, opening tenders, evaluation, signature, ethic clauses. We are progressing very well, as you can see. And now we are in the part of the draft contract. Contract number, normally we will insert when the contract is going to be prepared. If there are substantially two alternatives, either you have the tradition to give a number to each contract, so you will have to follow the numbering that you have used so far, and when it will be the moment to prepare this contract, you will give a number. Or if you don't have a tradition of numbering the contract, you can use the tender reference that we were using. let's assume that you have your own tradition of number in the contract. In this case, this contract will be contract number, I don't know, 277. We will see in a later moment. It's important to point out that the parts that in the standard dossier are in red. These are only the parts that are in the contract part, in the contract. These are to be filled in the moment that the contract is going to be prepared, not in the moment the tender dossier is prepared. All the parts in yellow must be addressed now, before launching the tender. All the parts in red later on, when the contract is going to be awarded, when the contract is going to be prepared. Because this part in red, you will know only at that time who, what is the number with the contractor, or what is the price, and so on and so forth. Name of the organization financing the project, that is in the procurement notice under clause 4, we remember by heart anyway, and we can write it down. I think the example that it is financed by the European Union, the government of Montenegro, and the municipality of Spaccaforno. This part here will be filled in later on when we know who has had the contract awarded. Very important not to forget that you can't know it in advance. If you know it in advance, something went really wrong. This is an example to be eliminated because we have already written down what it is. We were already filling in this part, and we said that we are looking for the supply, delivery, unloading, installation, commissioning, we were eliminating, maintenance, we were keeping, after sales service, we were eliminating. And in this part of the contract, it's important to write the name of the item and the quantity that you have in your technical specification. Of course, there could be some changes, because sometimes before you sign the contract, you activate the clause 22 of the general conditions, asking for some modification that you want, instead of 10 printers, you want 12 printers, instead of 5 computers, you want 7 computers, so there is a possibility to change something. So you can also activate these changes before signing the contract. So in this case, you should amend this table that was prepared before. But it is banal, it's something that you can do by yourself, no problem. This is the place of acceptance. This one was forgotten. It will be the same address that is in the here, the address of the contracting authority, let's assume. So let's copy and paste. One second. Voila. We have forgotten to highlight this part here. We do it now. It happens. And then the DP above, the implementation period shall run from the commencement date and no later than, we said 90 days, that is this day that is very normally, very commonly used for implementation period. The price information we will provide later on. We cancel this example because it is, but we know that we have an example for our calculations. Article 4, this one is going to be signed later on. special conditions, the law applicable will be the Montenegrin law. Communication for the contractor, all this part will have to be filled in when we know who is the contractor. The EU co-financing of the project, we said before, it is 75%. And again, here, the implementation period shall be 90 days. Inspection and testing, method of payment, that will be most probably the financial department of the municipality of Spaccaforno. You see in your organization who is in charge of the payments, who is dealing with this important issue. Here, this is important to mention to facilitate at the border eventually the entrance of the product without paying customs. It's always good to have a reference to the program of the European Union, to the reference to of this tender, that not by chance is including the reference to the European Union, not the Europaid, because it helps to be recognized as okay, let's go in the beginning. Here we have it is going to be recognized as a product that is co-financed by the European Union and that is going to facilitate the import of these goods if they are imported. If we have invited, this is a competitive negotiated procedure, so if we have invited the companies that are coming from abroad, where were we? We have gone a bit too ahead. Voila. So the package. Most probably, anyway, if it is a competitive negotiated implement with companies that are all based in Montenegro, like it, we would expect in this case, this reference is not really helping nobody. But we have it as a standard format, and we use it. The warranty period, we said that is 1 year. 1 year. And jurisdiction of Montenegro. Let's continue. These are the general conditions. You see them in this way because in order to help you to see in the monitor what is written, I was enlarging, but when I take it back to the normal size times 12, it will be properly done the page formatting. These are all the general conditions. I love them because they are always the same, they don't change, so we can go very fast. We expect nothing to happen. After the JAC condition, there is an annex 2 and 3 that we have already filled in, we said. And after that, we are approaching the end of the project. We have to include a few more numbers and specifications and items. Let's copy and insert here. In the annex for the tender reference. Now we go to the forms. This part was already, you have to include now the country. Montenegro. We have to include in all the guarantee the information related to the legislation relevant and the competent court. So we can pass Montenegro. Let's go to the next one. Montenegro. And here again, Montenegro. We facilitate our own life. That is good. This also, in the normal format, it is easy to be seen. That is a financial identification form. It is very relevant in order to make then the payment to the contractor. These are the information about the bank. Then we have the legal entity file. Also this one will shrink in the normal format. Legal entity file for public bodies. Further information, this administrative compliance grid is there. Evaluation grid for the technical evaluation is there. Tender form for supply contract, that is something that is going to be filled in mainly by our grant beneficiary. They will insert this part here. We can highlight it because it is not supposed to be highlighted. It was just a mistake. Contact person, economic and financial data. So now only the tender guarantee we have to complete. That is the last page. The tender declaration, we have to. The date of the procurement notice. So the procurement notice was published on the 27/07/2013. And finally, we have the tender guarantee that is in the last page. No, we don't have. Well, we have the tender guarantee form, but actually this is a small mistake. We'll amend it in the final version of the documents I'm going to make public, because in the tender under competitive negotiated procedure, we said that we don't ask them to provide us a tender guarantee. So it is not necessary, this form. So it can stay there, but it would create just a bit of confusion, so we will eliminate. Okay, thanks a lot for your attention. I hope that this tender procedure for the supply for supply under competitive negotiated is of your interest and that you will be using in the implementation of your grant project. Thank you again.